Wee woo, wee woo.
This is an urgent message. Now that the election is over...
The election isn't over until the electoral...
Shut up!
Now that the election is over, let's focus on something else. Why haven't you gotten the flu shot yet? Oh, you did? Show me your immune system. I'm just joking, but this year, like many before it, we are already stepping into the flu season. And this year more than ever, it's very important to get your flu shot. And I can already hear some of you in the comments flooding in. But Atris, I never get the flu. But Atris, there's mercury in it. But Atris, I already got my vaccine. Excuses. I am going to briefly explain why you are wrong about the vaccine and why it's perfectly safe and nearly everybody should get it. Let's start with some of the more common reasons why people think that the flu shot is bad. 1. It has dangerous chemicals that will harm you. The vaccine is comprised of a few components, and bear in mind most vaccines are about 0.5 milliliters of fluid, and that's this much. It has a small amount of formaldehyde, which in large doses is dangerous, yes, but the amount in this vial is less than the formaldehyde already naturally in your body. Formaldehyde's role in the vaccine is to inactivate toxins from the viruses and bacteria that may contaminate it. There's also aluminum salts, which are also in drinking water, and various other health products such as antacids, antiperspirants. They're not always present in the vaccines, and some of which are aluminum-free. This allows scientists to include smaller amounts of inactivated viruses, making it safer. There may be chicken-egg protein in some vaccines as well, because vaccines are usually grown inside fertilized chicken eggs. The Center for Disease Control even says if you have an allergy to egg or egg protein, you could still get the standard flu vaccine, but you just have to be evaluated by a doctor. And if you can't, there's options to get it without the egg protein. Small amounts of gelatin are present in the flu shot as a stabilizer. It helps keep the vaccine effective from the point of production to the moment of use. Most flu vaccines use pork-based gelatin or squalene oil as a stabilizer. Squalene oil is made from fish, for all my vegetarians out there. And finally, there's a teeny tiny amount of antibiotics, and this just helps stop bacteria from growing in the vaccine while it's in storage. And bear in mind, once again, all of those ingredients are in this amount of fluid. So the overall amounts are infinitesimal. Now, some of you anti-vaxxers out there are already saying, well, Atris, you forgot about the murder chemical, the ever-dangerous thimerosal.
Incorrect! I forget nothing.
Thimerosal hasn't been used in vaccines as a preservative for over 7 years. It's still used in multi-dose vials, which are no longer given in mass quantities, but the mercury in it has been removed due to the criticism, even though the mercury was more similar to the mercury in fish rather than the poisonous methylmercury.
Hey guys, editing Atris here. I tried to explain this concept to a patient previously, but they said, oh, but even a little bit of poison is bad. Well, number one, it's not poison, and number two, large amounts of pure salt can be explosive and toxic, but we eat that stuff daily.
Number two, the vaccine makes me sick.
No, it doesn't.
Oh, they want an explanation? Fine. The wide use of live virus flu vaccines hasn't been used for over a decade. The most common version of the flu shot we all get is a dead virus. That means in the lab, they kill the virus off so that when they put it in your body, it reacts as if the virus is there, giving your body a chance to build up antibodies. Now, the immune response does cause a bit of flushing. It can cause some soreness and headaches. But if you're getting sick during the flu season, it's probably because you caught the flu during the flu season. People get sick, especially during this time. And with your immune system already altered to possible infection the moment it detects new virus, it could go into attack mode, actually helping a lot quicker. The flu shot will not stop you from getting the flu. It can help prevent it, and it has shown, by the CDC's own standards, a 60% improvement for those who got the vaccine over those who didn't in recovery time. And survival rate in the elderly has a massive improvement for those who have gotten the vaccine. 3. If it doesn't stop me from getting sick, why am I getting it? Because, just like I said previously, it may not stop you from getting the flu, but it will help you get better faster if you do catch the flu. The virus mutates every year, it changes, and scientists have to try and keep up with the new vaccine, the new strain every year. It's a guessing game. Sometimes they guess wrong, but as the old adage goes, saying I don't need to get a flu shot because I don't get sick is like saying I don't need to wear a seatbelt because I don't crash. 4, I don't need a flu shot because I don't get sick. Oh, you really aren't listening. Okay, well, how about this? Similar to COVID, the flu vaccine is your mask and social distancing. It's good for you, you don't get sick, but others may. Having everybody immunized for this season's flu prevents the spread of a seasonal virus by 60%+, especially in recent decades. But I've never gotten sick, I've never gotten the flu, so I don't need a flu shot. If you've never gotten the flu shot, and you've never had the flu, then you have no immunity to it. I had a patient come in the other day who said that same thing, and she's 80. That means that if she catches the flu at 80 with no immunity or antibodies, she will likely die. 5, but what if I'm at risk? Wouldn't getting the vaccine harm me? Again, the flu shot doesn't have a virus in it. And even with allergies, there are other options. But it actually is advised that if you are compromised, you should get a shot. The only people that shouldn't get the vaccine are babies less than 6 months old, anyone with Guillain-Barré syndrome, and people with life-threatening allergies to any ingredient in the vaccine. That leaves a list of a whole lot of other people. Are you feeling sick? You can get the flu shot. Are you elderly? You can get the flu shot. Are you on chemotherapy and immunosuppressed? You should get a higher dose of the flu shot. Diabetes? Flu shot. Depressed? Flu shot. Taking antibiotics? Flu shot. Have the flu? Flu shot. And before you ask, no, it will not put you at a higher risk for catching COVID. The flu shot is a tried and true, decades-long experimented, tested, and confirmed vaccine. Unlike the coming COVID vaccine, it's not experimental, you're not a guinea pig or a test subject, this is just a protection that we should all have. This year has been so crazy, with so many things being canceled due to it. The last thing we need is a high rate of influenza infections because people are afraid of gelatin and egg protein. Listen, I know it hurts, and nobody wants to go to the doctor or the pharmacy, but look, there is a public health crisis going on. The flu shot is free to all, depending on where you live in the world and where you go. Mostly talking about America, sorry. And at absolute most, it might make you a little sore. So just take time to think about yourself, your community, and others. And just go to the dang grocery store and get your flu shot.
And before you think it's too late to go out and get your flu shot, it's not too late. We give them all the way up until technically June. I'll leave resources down below in the description for frequently asked questions, CDC resources, and places that you can go to get your flu shot.
If any other questions arise from this video, please ask them in the comments below, and I'll answer as many as you need. I give about 30 to 40 flu vaccines a day. And honestly, it's not enough if we're tracking the grand scheme, because when it comes down to it, it's really the only protection we have. The only other thing that could possibly help in any crisis is
Stardust LEDs! That's right, all of this was a Stardust LEDs ad.
Looking to transform your room into that vaporwave aesthetic? Check out StardustLEDs.com for premium lights perfect for any room. Use the code in the description for 10% off your order.